information, it's all in the PECs. So what are the PECs doing? The PECs are accelerating, they're doing this. That's called, for the right arm, that's called adduction, okay? And that's the reason why maybe Hogan felt connected. Because if I do this and squeeze my PECs, I know Brendan, you were working on some isometric stuff with some tubing. If everyone did this and just squeezed PECs, very connected. It's muscle activation. So again, this is some of the rationale. What I want to look at is I've always talked right hand, couldn't explain it to this detail about the reasons why. And I didn't, so we don't even know the motor program here. We just know that it was PGA and LPGA tour players. This is from Dr. Ferdinand's out of Australia. So obviously, first one I put, as you go through this, X factor and X factor stretch, there's no correlation to club head speed. So now we can save your back. We can save your lumbar spine, which is not designed to rotate, designed to support. Now also, as we kind of go down into this, when we look at contributions, pelvis contribution is 10 to 15% to the club head speed. So when does that happen? Through the ball. That's where I want it to add. Now, in transition, it actually states in the research it's 85% in transition, but what's the club, how fast is that club moving in transition to your better shots? Not fast at all. So that's just kind of the reaction that we have. Then obviously, this last little bit is just talking about the horizontal orientation is more important into the downswing, which is that functional swing plane. So if it's horizontal, which direction is that? Towards the target. Not forward, because forward, so I don't know if Richard told me or Jordan, forward's that way. I said, okay, towards the target, okay? So those are the things I get to learn from you guys. So this is just looking at the where the power comes from. Looking at it, power on the right, highest one is right upper arm adduction, which is this. These are right-hand golfers. Okay. So again, we see the pecs, highest activation. We see the wrist going to extension to flexion. So what am I doing? That's it. And it just shows you that, this is just staying at the left arm, provides very little to the downswing, power of the downswing.
Okay. Show us that on the graph where the left arm is providing very little
power.
Yeah.
Right here.
And which one's the right arm? Is the peak or is it more?
Peak right here.
Oh, okay.
So when you look at right upper arm. Now, what Bain talks about is it's not this. It's this. But that's the reason why you see the arm can be bent. Yes, sir.
If you watch a lot of Gary Player, he swears it's all here. It's in
correct.
The court. But is he really hitting the way you're...
Yes, now here's what it is, and this gets into other research that I have put in here, but I can actually pull that up. Core stiffness allows us to have ballistic limb segment higher velocities. Now what does that mean? Okay, does anyone do any type of boxing training or martial arts or anything like that?
A little bit.
A little bit, okay. When you go and strike somebody, how is your core tight, or is your core just really soft and relaxed?
Tight.
Yes. Well, what do? We're accelerating our arms. So again, that we need that post of tightness in order to accelerate the distal segments. That's where that's coming in from. So again, feels tight in the core. We feel tight connected, but guess what? I can't move very fast this way. So that's just the misinterpretation. It's not even a misinterpretation, that's what they feel.
Yeah.
But when they write that in the books, they communicate that, great players, what I want you guys to do is not ever remember what I said. I want to, all of a sudden you guys go, I'm hitting great shots, and I ask you, well, why? How are you doing it? And you go, I don't know, I just do it. That is the greatest tribute I could ever receive from a student, is when they do that to me. They just know, okay? Flip, I know you drive trucks, right? How much thinking do you do mechanically when you're driving a truck? You're not looking at your hands, not looking at your feet. He's aware of the situation and reacting to different things. He's just saying it's aware of the situation and he's reacting. If he sees a car pull out, he's going to slow down or whatever he's got to do. There's not a thought. That's why we want you to play golf. Okay? So Marty's biggest challenge is doing that. He got mad at me because, this is what Brendan told me, that because I only gave him like this much and he wanted the whole bottle. It's like, no, you only need a couple pills. Two aspirin's fine. You don't need 100. But his change that he made was phenomenal. Now today we can really jump into the next stage. Because why? He's got a solid foundation, you know? So that was phenomenal. Okay, so that's pretty much, I just wanted to kind of share with you guys some basic behind the scenes validation of where this is all coming from. Okay, now from a motor control standpoint, when we go out there and teach, I don't talk about, did I use the word right arm aid induction in any of the information? No, because that now we're going to shift it into a motor control. So this is all biomechanical stuff that I study, EMG, 3D stuff, and blah, blah, blah. So now we got to say, okay, how do we take this information and apply it? Well, it's like throwing a ball. It's like throwing a punch. It's like using a hammer. Now we got to shift it from information into movement. And the only way to do that is to actually do it. Okay, any questions? I don't see anyone injured today, so that's a good sign. Okay? Any questions with what we did yesterday? And we'll obviously jump into that. But anything that you want to ask? So I'm really pleased with what I saw, what we got accomplished with the weather yesterday with everybody. Very pleased. So I'm going to add more stuff today to see if we can even make it better.